tell you, I was at a number of grocery stores myself over the weekend, and it didn't matter the time of day or what the store itself was. They were very busy, and it was very specific items across those different stores that seemed to be sold out. What are you seeing in your Stu Leonard's locations right now?
Well, we're definitely seeing panic right now, and we've seen that for the last really 3-4 days, really since Trump gave his speech that first night. And everybody's out there worried right now. They want to get food. They want to stock up. We've seen water fly out of here. We've seen paper towels. And the thing that amazes me is toilet paper. It's one of the biggest sellers. But, you know, one of the things I did, I mean, they're buying things like this now, like fresh squeezed orange juice, because you can freeze it. The meat right now is literally, everybody's buying it. You can freeze it. You know, we have these fresh fish here, salmon like this, that's all frozen. This stuff, they're just gobbling up and putting in their freezers at home. So you're seeing a lot of people buying product and freezing it. And then you're seeing the hard goods and staples like water, cereal, paper towel, tissue, all that. They're really filling their carts up with it.
Yeah. How concerned are you about supply chain disruption or the potential for that here? How quickly can you get some of these items back on store shelves?
Well, one of the things we've been very fortunate about is we buy direct from the suppliers. So the producers, the farms, we get direct loads from them. So we've been really lucky right now to get food. And as you can see, we got plenty of food here at Stu Leonard's, fortunately. Makes me feel good. We've been in business 50 years and we're supplying our customers and giving them what they want right now. But we're seeing some disruption from California right now. It's getting tight out there. They also just had a little bit of rain, which hurt them a little more. But we have other sources of fresh fruits and vegetables that we can get. We've also seen a little disruption with salmon in Canada and the Bay of Fundy up there, but we're able now to, we're bringing up some salmon from Chile. I think most of your retailers, if they get the distribution part of it down and can get the products out there, we just have to get it in the stores. Except for a few items like toilet paper, Purell, masks we cannot buy on the market right now. You can see even Amazon has run out of a lot of things online. So, but it's mainly the fresh basics that you need. We feel there's good supply, and we'll have them here at Stu Leonard's.
Stu, I'm wondering about what's the smartest way for people to shop that would actually be helpful to you. Should people be ordering delivery instead of coming in? Are there practices that you wish people would employ to either shorten lines or get what they need more efficiently?
Well, you know what I'm finding, and I've been on the floor, you know, I was out in Long Island yesterday at our Farmingdale Nice Meadows store. There's a range of people's acceptance of the coronavirus. Some people are not worried at all, and they're just saying, I'm going about my daily day. Other people are petrified. So what we've done at the store is we're wiping everything down every hour, from the bathrooms to the registers to the keypads, pens. We're giving everybody a sani wipe. I was in Costco. They were giving me a sani wipe when I walked in. We have lots of Purell bottles around the store right now. So what I would just recommend everybody is I feel the, you know, we're doing our best job keeping the food safe, keeping our workers safe. They're all trained in food science. They're wearing gloves all the time. We're teaching them about keeping some distance and just using good hygiene all day long. I'm washing my hands like probably everybody watching today. I'm washing them maybe 20 times a day now. So I think taking normal precautions every single day is the way to go right now. I wouldn't be, personally, I don't think you have to be freaked out right now and say, I can't go out of my house.
Yeah.
That's my own personal opinion. Other people are different.
Yeah. Stu, I'm curious what you make of some of the response efforts that are coming out of the federal government right now. I mean, as the owner of a medium-sized business, something like a payroll tax cut, for example, how much would that help a business like yours in this time of uncertainty?
Well, I think it would help, and definitely I feel really bad for a lot of people. Like, look at all the restaurants right now that just got closed. We're a family business here, and I really feel for that because That's probably some family right now that had to close their restaurant. I mean, they still have rent, they still have electrical, they still have all these expenses, and it's really putting them in a hardship, and I think the federal government really has to do something to help that, not business, but family out at a tough time like this right now.
Stu Leonard Jr., thank you for joining us today.